Hello, welcome. In today's video, I bring you an exclusive list of updates. The controversial launch of the Strato emulator, Xynx, a new Nintendo Switch emulator for Android, a version of Acer SX2 with support for Turnip drivers that promises even more performance than the 1.9 developer version, and a fork of Xenia that allows online gameplay. Let's start with Acer SX2. For those with Snapdragon devices, it's known that to get even greater performance in emulators, you should use a Turnip driver, which is typically ported from another device, improved, and enhanced by the community. The video drivers for most devices cannot be updated in the same way as a conventional PC. Some emulators, like Acer SX2 and NetherRealm SX2, have had their development practically halted because the developers left the scene and, until now, do not support this type of driver modification. Recently, there was an update for the Acer SX2 port that allows the use of an external Turnip driver, which, according to its homepage, promises more FPS and smoother gameplay for your PlayStation 2 games on Android. The development team reported that many players, including those with Snapdragon 660 devices, have started to have a more acceptable experience using this version. I haven't had time to test this project yet, but I will do so within 2 weeks and post my verdict for you. You can export all your progress from Acer SX2 or NetherRealm SX2 and import it into this version with Turnip directly from the project's initial menu, so you won't lose any of your previous progress. In the tests I did on the new NetherRealm SX2 version, which you can check out in the video in the card and also in the description, I had improvements in many aspects. For example, I can now play God of War 2 at 1080p with fixed 60fps, but I still found many problems in games from the Need for Speed franchise. A new project with Turnip drivers could provide me with excellent experiences. If you want any specific games tested, leave them in the comments. An update, folks. I tested the project with Turnip on my ROG Phone 6 with Android 14 and Snapdragon 8 Plus Gen 1, but unfortunately, the app doesn't even start. I've read in some places that it might not work with Snapdragon 8, but it could work with GPUs from the 600 and 800 series. The second topic we will address is the new port of Xenia Canary, which now allows you to play Xbox 360 games online directly through the emulator. The system works similarly to RPCS3. Where you don't directly access Microsoft servers but a private network created for this purpose. The configuration is quite simple, requiring just a few parameter changes. There is also a website where you can view all the information on ongoing sessions. At the time of recording this video, which was in the afternoon, a time with fewer players online, there were at least 4 GTA 4 sessions, 1 Midnight Club Los Angeles session, and other games I didn't recognize, so I won't mention them. You can play the entire Gears of War franchise and other major titles. In total, there are over 350 compatible games, including the Call of Duty franchise, and it supports mouse gameplay. Given the number of people playing, the easiest way to play online is to arrange with friends or strangers, or you'll end up mainly playing GTA 4. Before we move on to the news about Switch emulators, don't forget to leave a like to help the channel grow even more. If this is your first time here, consider subscribing to receive new videos every week. Do you remember the successor to Skyline, the old Switch emulator for Android that was discontinued due to developers' fear of being sued by Nintendo? That successor was supposed to be Strato. Strato was a dream project for many until the arrival of Yuzu with NC, which diverted attention to new projects. However, Strato is not just a fork of Yuzu. There was anticipation that Strato would be released on June 27th, the date on which I am creating this video. However, rumors have surfaced that the developer was pushing this date due to fan pressure, which generated a lot of hate. The community is questioning whether the project is just a group of kids, as they previously promised the emulator would be released in mid-year, but that date has already passed. According to these rumors, if Strato were released today, it would probably disappoint everyone, remembering that it is developed by just one person. They say that an early release would result in inferior performance compared to Yuzu, generating even more hate, as this is the only native Switch emulator for Android, unlike Yuzu ports that are adapted from Windows to Android. If you are familiar with the Android scene, you know how much hate and even threats the developer of Acer SX2 received until he abandoned the project. Finally, we have Xynx, the Nintendo Switch emulator for Android that was receiving major updates and, at the same time, a lot of hate from its community. For those who don't know, Xynx is a performance-focused version, similar to Citroen MJ. Since this emulator emerged, several influencers tested it and detected viruses in its code, recommending not to use the project. Personally, I prefer not to be the first to test these types of projects that are immediately flagged as a threat to my device. However, It didn't take long for several people to claim that the project was legitimate and offered slightly better performance than Yuzu and even Sudachi. Currently, the project is in version 6. There was a leak of a conversation on Telegram where the alleged developer admitted to simply taking the Sudachi code, rebranding it, and inserting a virus. This led to the deletion of the Telegram community, which was soon rebuilt. The developer, for his part, claims that the screenshots are fake. On its GitHub page, the following message was added: some rumors and fake chats spread it telling that Xiaoyongs has a virus which is completely false. Thousands of people tried it, and no devices got broken or any data go stolen, and you can check the Telegram channel that no one got affected from installing the app, and I assure you that, and the reason behind the two risks detected in VirusTotalWebEast is because we use Antutu benchmark and that interfere with VirusTotal but versions without Antutu, like V3.5 showed clean results. I also have no experiences in making viruses, especially in a virus for Android, and there is no reason for me to make a virus to track you, steal passwords, etc. And I don't know how to make them. In conclusion, don't believe anything you see on internet. Even so, I urge you to be cautious with this project. It might be better to wait a bit longer before testing it. I'll leave the links for all the projects mentioned in this video in the description, where you can obtain them for free. And that was our video. Thank you for your audience, and see you next time.